This is WPDE, News Channel 15 at 6, with Allison Floyd and Jim Heath.
6 years ago, John McCain was on the verge of capturing the Republican nomination for president, but South Carolina voters had other ideas. In the 2000 New Hampshire primary, Arizona Senator John McCain stunned the political establishment, winning a decisive victory over Texas Governor George W. Bush. His campaign then moved on with momentum to South Carolina. A win here could have knocked Bush out of the race.
John McCain, character, courage for president.
In Myrtle Beach, it was all smiles.
NASCAR Cafe, and I thank you very much.
But Bush's campaign, desperate for a win, pulled out all the stops. Upstate, Bush spoke to conservatives at evangelical Bob Jones University, where McCain had refused to appear.
It feels a lot warmer here in the state of South Carolina, if you know what I mean.
And on television, South Carolinians were seeing this.
Saying one thing and doing another. That's the real John McCain.
A nasty whisper campaign even suggested McCain's Bangladesh-born daughter was his own illegitimate black child.
Someone told me that Senator McCain is a cheat and a liar and a fraud.
What you've just told me has had a very profound effect on me. I hope that people would contact the Bush campaign and tell them not to do that.
The allegations have never been proven, and so I guess you could classify them as scurrilous. But that took McCain out of the race.
CNN is prepared to declare a winner. He is Texas Governor George W. Bush.
The South Carolina results crushed McCain, ending his presidential dreams.
I want the presidency in the best way, not the worst way.
Now, 6 years later, John McCain returned to the upstate.
Senator, good to see you.
Thank you, Jim. It's good to see you again.
Let me ask you, you're in the upstate. You gave a great line when you gave a little speech before you autographed the books today about your feelings about being back in South Carolina.
I said, slept like a baby after we were defeated here. And I said, I slept like a baby, sleep for 2 hours, wake up and cry, sleep for 2 hours, wake up and cry.
What is it with conservatives where John McCain has trouble?
I'm not sure that I have that much trouble. I was defeated in 2000, not by religious conservatives, although that was certainly part of it, but I was defeated by the Republican establishment. President Bush had the entire Republican establishment behind him and all the money that that entails.
In 2008, McCain will need a big chunk of conservative delegates to be the Republican nominee.
For your moderate and Democratic supporters out there, should they be concerned?
If they're Democrats and independents that are supportive of me, it's not so much because of my stance on Pacific issues. It's because they believe that I do what I think is right.
And a good example of doing what McCain thinks is right are two upstate appearances. In Spartanburg, over 600 Republicans, many of whom did not support his candidacy in 2000, pay $50 up to hear him speak. But for 45 minutes, McCain makes them wait as he addresses a predominantly Democratic group, here reciting a letter written by Martin Luther King Jr.
Daddy, why do white people treat colored people so mean?
Less than an hour later, McCain is back at the Marriott addressing the Republicans.
But we Republicans have got to clean up our act, make these much-needed reforms, and get back on the track.
John McCain's moderate streak cost him the nomination in 2000, but upstate conservatives now say it could be a huge advantage.
Right now, he would absolutely be the front runner, and I think a lot of that has to do with potentially Hillary Clinton be the Democrats, that Republicans, conservative, moderates, and so forth are looking at John McCain would be our best hope at that.
The smiles from South Carolina's 2000 presidential primary were short-lived for Senator John McCain.
The candidate who was trounced by John McCain in New Hampshire has been resurrected in the Palmetto State.
I will never dishonor the nation I love or myself by letting ambition overcome principle. Never. Never. Never.
God
bless you.
Thank you.
Now, just 24 months before the next primary, McCain returned to the upstate. There may be no other American who's invited to attend as many diverse events in a single day. How is it that two nearly opposite groups in one upstate community can be so comfortable welcoming this particular politician? October 26, 1967. Navy Flyer McCain was shot down over Vietnam and held prisoner of war at the infamous Hanoi Hilton. While there, he was kept in a small cell, regularly beaten.
I would just like to tell my wife that I don't get well. I love her.
He could have come home several years before he did if he had wanted to step into the front of the line. That part of his history speaks very well for him as a man of honor.
After 5.5 years, McCain was finally released from captivity in 1973.
On the issue of torture, why do you think the president took so long to realize that you were not going to budge on that issue?
I'm not sure. I know that from the beginning we had fruitful discussions. They were always friendly, and I think that the president realized that the majority of Congress strongly supported this proposal.
On Iraq, McCain's current position is in contrast to a similar situation 20 years ago.
I would not support and will not support sending U.S. troops to Nicaragua, and I don't think the majority of the American people would support such a thing. And Richard, I think you should rethink your position on a very dangerous and reckless policy of sending young men to fight and die in the jungles of Central America.
Some would argue 20 years later that that's where we're at in Iraq.
Well, it's vastly different, and the Nicaraguans never had any remote possibility of acquiring weapons of mass destruction.
It is because I owe America more than she has ever owed me that I am a candidate for President of the United States.
With a formal announcement of his White House bid expected next January, John McCain enjoys another advantage here that he didn't in 2000. Gone is longtime Senator Strom Thurmond, replaced by Lindsey Graham, one of McCain's best friends.
South Carolina is the third primary, and 2008 is the first primary in the South. It will be a hugely important event. John has been well received, and conservatives who believe in controlling spending, John McCain is your guy.
Could South Carolina, if you can win here, unlike 2000, could that wrap up a Republican nomination for a Senator John McCain?
You know, I don't know, Jim, because I think there are other states now. I understand Alabama may be moving in and other states may be, but I don't think there's any doubt that South Carolina remains a very important state. Now, whether it's the critical state or not, I don't know.
Do you ever think to yourself, of 300 million Americans, I'm among just a handful that very likely could occupy the Oval Office?
Remember, I'm the guy that stood fifth from the bottom of his class at the Naval Academy. but of course, I'm honored and humbled.